So today's class we will start with the divisive hierarchical clustering algorithm known as DINA, that is divisive analysis. In divisive hierarchical clustering, we are uses the top-down approach. So initially, all objects are considered as a single cluster. Here in this case, there are five objects, A, B, C, D, E. Initially, all these objects are in the same cluster. That is the step one. In the next step, this single cluster is divided into two clusters. Here, A, B, C, D is split into two clusters, A, B and C, D. Again, in the next step, the cluster A, B is further divided into two clusters. The single cluster with objects AB is divided into two clusters with objects A and B. In the fourth step, the object CD is divided into two clusters CD and E. Finally, in the last step, the cluster CD is divided into objects C and D. So in the top, initially the divisive clustering starts with the entire object as a cluster, then the objects are divided into two separate clusters. Again, each group of objects are divided into two clusters, and we continue this process until each object becomes a single cluster. This is the approach used in hierarchical clustering using divisive method. Divisive clustering algorithm begins with the entire data set as a single cluster. Then we recursively divide one of the existing clusters into two daughter clusters at each iteration. So this is a top-down approach. Here we need an algorithm to divide a given data set into two clusters. We have already studied a method in which we used k-means clustering algorithm to divide a cluster into two clusters. In this study, we are using another approach, DINA, that is divisive analysis. DINA is a divisive hierarchical clustering technique. The outline of the algorithm is like this. In the first step, we are assuming that the cluster CN, that is the whole object CL, is going to be split into clusters CI and CJ. So for that, we will assign CI as CL and CJ as null set or empty. So CI will contain the whole objects as single cluster, and CJ will be empty. Now for each object X in CI, for the first iteration, we will compute the average distance of x to all other objects. Then for the remaining iterations, we will compute the distance of x. In the first iteration, there will be only single cluster with object. The second cluster will be empty. So in the first iteration, we can compute the distance of average distance of x to all other objects. But in the second case, remaining iteration, there will be two clusters. So for finding the distance of an object, we have to find out the distance of the object within that cluster as well as the distance of object from the objects in the other cluster. So the average distance of the object in the same cluster minus the average distance of object or distance of the object with the objects in the other cluster. This difference is taken to find out the distance value. So in the second iteration, consider the object x. To find the distance value of x, we have to find out the distance of x from all the objects within the cluster CI and also the distance of x from all objects in CJ. We have to take the average value of these two and take the difference to find the distance of object x. Then, in the step 4, the first iteration, we move the object with the maximum average distance to Cj. And for the remaining iteration, we find the object x in Ci for which dx is largest. And if dx is greater than 0, then we move object x to Cj. This process is repeated until all differences are negative. So we split the cluster Cl into Ci and Cj. Now in the sixth step, we select the smaller cluster with the largest diameter. The diameter of the cluster is the largest dissimilarity between any two of its objects. Then divide this cluster. Then we repeat the steps 1 to 5 and repeat step until all clusters contain only a single object. So we have initially, now when you consider the problem, here the data set consists of 5 objects A, B, C, D. And initially we are assuming that CL contains all the objects A, B, C, D as a single cluster. And we assign Ci as CL and Cj as null set for empty. This is the distance matrix which is already given. Based on this, we have to find out the clustering using the Divisi analysis approach. So in the initial iteration, we are calculating the average dissimilarity of object Ci with other objects in Ci. For that, we have to find out the average dissimilarity of object A. So in the cluster, there are objects A, B, C, D, and E. So we have to find out the average dissimilarity of object A, object B, object C, object D, and object E. Find out the average dissimilarity of object A, we have to find out the distance from A to B, A to C, A to D, and A to E. Here one term is missing. Distance from A to D is also included. So we have to find out the sum of all these distance and find the average. So that is 1 by 4 into 9 plus 3 plus 6 plus 11. It is 7.25. Similarly, we can find out the average distance of B. That is distance of B from A, distance of B from C, distance of B from E, and distance of B from D. Take all these distance, take the sum and divide by 4, and you will get the value of 7.75. Similarly, we can find out the average dissimilarity of C and D and E. Now the highest average distance is 7.75. So there are two objects with this average distance. We can consider the average distance of all the objects. A is 7.25, B is 7.75, C is 5.25, D 7, E 7.75. So two objects, B and D, both are having the average distance as 7.75, and that is the highest value. So we can consider any one of the objects. Now we are considering B. B is having the largest dissimilarity, and so we are taking B and combining it with the Cj. So now the cluster Ci becomes ACDE, and B is removed from this Ci and it is joined with the Cj, because Cj, B is the object with the highest dissimilarity. So Cj is, there is only one member in the cluster Cj, that is B, object B. Now we can find out the distance, average distance, by using this method. That means now we are having two clusters, two separate clusters. So when you find out, when we have to find out the distance of an object, we have to find out the distance of the object from the objects in the same cluster and also from the objects in the other cluster. So we have to sum all these distances, and also this sum all these distances, take the average and take the difference. In cluster CI, there are four objects A, C, D, E, and cluster CJ, there is only one object, that is B. Now in the second iteration, we are finding the distance of A. For that, we have to find out the distance of A from C, A from D, A from E, and also A from B. Then take the average of these two values and take the difference. So 1 by 3 of distance AC, distance AD, distance AE minus 1 by 1 of distance AB. That is equal to 20 by 3 minus 9. That is equal to minus 2.33. Similarly, when we want to find out the distance of C, in this case, the distance of C should be calculated from A, B, and D. Take the sum and find the average. Similarly, distance of C from B should be calculated and take the average. So that is 1 by 3 of distance CA plus distance CD plus distance CE minus 1 by 1 distance CB. That is 14 minus 3 minus 7. That is minus 2.33. Similarly, you can find out the distance of D. That is 1 by 3 minus distance of DA, distance of DC, distance of DE minus 1 by 1 into, here there is a mistake, it is 1 by 1 into distance of DB, distance of D from B. So it is equal to 23 by 3 minus 7, that is 0.67. Similarly, we can find out the distance of E from other objects and from B, and it is 0. So in this case, the highest dissimilarity value is for the object D. So we can move D is the largest and D is greater than 0. So we move D to CJ. So now we have two clusters, ACE as one cluster and CJ is another cluster with the objects B and D. So in the third iteration, we have to find out the dissimilarity value of A, C, and E. Only these three objects, so that one object can be moved to the other cluster. That is, when you calculate the dissimilarity of A, you have to take the distance from A and C, A and D. Then distance of A from B and A from D. So distance A is 1 by 2, distance AC plus distance AE minus 1 by 2, distance AB plus distance AD. That is 14 by 2 minus 15 by 2. That is minus 0.5. Similarly, distance C, that is 1 by 2, distance CA plus distance C minus half distance CB plus distance CD. Similarly, you can find the distance of object D, that is distance of object E from A, distance of object E from C. Take the average. Then distance of E from B, distance of E from D. Take the average. That is minus 1 by 2 D distance of EA plus distance of EC minus 1 by 2 distance of EB plus distance of AD. That is 13 by 2 minus 18 by 2, which is minus 2.5. Now, when we consider all the distance measures, we can find that all are negative. So, we stop and form clusters CA and CJ. Now, we have to decide which cluster should be divided again. So, the cluster, for that, we have to find out the diameter of both the clusters. Diameter of the cluster is the maximum distance between any two objects in the cluster. So in the cluster CA, there are three objects A, C, and D. So we have to find out the distance AC, distance AE, and distance CE. Then we have to take the maximum value. So the distance maximum of 3, 11, 12, maximum value is 11. So the diameter of cluster CA is 11. And in cluster CJ, there are only two objects. So we are finding out the distance from B to D, and that is only 5, and the maximum value is 5. So in this case, the cluster with the maximum diameter is CI. So next step, we will divide cluster CI. For that, we are repeating the same process. That means we assign CL as ACE and we assign, take two clusters CI and CJ. CI is assigned with the value CL and CJ will be empty. And like that, we can repeat the process until all objects A, C, D, A, B, C, D is a single cluster. So you can continue this process and find out how ACE is again divided into two clusters. So we have already studied about a new approach of DBC hierarchical clustering known as the divisive analysis algorithm, in which we are dividing the clusters based on the dissimilarity measure. The dissimilarity measure is calculated based on the average distance. There is only a single cluster, we can find out the average distance by taking the distance of an object from another object and taking the average. But when there are two clusters, we have to use the formula like this for finding out the distance of an object. So we have to find the distance of the object from the objects within the cluster as well as from the object in the other cluster. Take the average value of these two distances and find the distance, find the difference. And the object having the largest dissimilarity, this is the dissimilarity value, largest dissimilarity will be removed from that particular cluster and joined with the other cluster. This is how one single cluster is divided into two clusters.